coming at you with another unboxing video here. Today I have not one, but three pairs of boots to show you. This is the Red Wing shoes in three flavors. I've been eyeing Red Wings for a while. I love how they look. I love how the leather looks. When I bought my first pair of boots, I looked hard at Red Wings before I ended up going with the Allen Edmonds. They've been something that's on my radar for a while. So when I saw a pretty good sale pop up on Nordstrom Rack, I thought that I'd snag a couple. Now, just so you know, Nordstrom Rack generally sells factory seconds. So a couple of these that I got are factory seconds. One of the pairs is not. I'll kind of talk about the difference that I see in those. So three pairs of boots here, two mock toes. One of them is the Blacksmith, the copper rough and tough. So let's just get started with these Blacksmiths here. First of all, you have the nice Red Wing box. You can tell that it's a factory second by, if you see there, factory second is stamped on the box. You can also tell that a boot is a factory second by this little punch in the tongue here. So I don't know if you can see that at all, but there's a little tiny punch hole there. That means that there's probably just something cosmetically or some minor flaw in these that that causes them to be a factory second. Honestly, looking at this boot right off the bat here, I really don't see anything that's gonna make me think, you know, that this is gonna be a bad boot by any means. I think what it could be is we have a little bit of variation in the leather grain here. That could be, you know, just if they didn't have a smooth grain, they could have kicked it out to a factory second. Honestly, I kind of like it. The thing I like about the copper rough and tough leather, which is honestly one of my favorite colors I've ever seen, is just how beautiful it looks. And that variation, I think, with the oils and that vegetable tan leather, I think over time it's just going to wear beautifully. So first impression of the boot is, honestly, this one. This is the Blacksmith boot. It's a little bit of a, probably plays second fiddle a little bit to their classic Iron Ranger. Iron Ranger is their cap toe. This one, right off the bat I noticed, has a 270 degree welt. So you can see here the welt goes here, stops at the heel. Gives it a little bit of a slimmer look, which for me is probably good. I work in an office, and so I can probably wear this boot around the office, whereas the Iron Ranger, like, you can tell that's a work boot. It's pretty bulky and it's got that really bulbous toe box. This one's a little more slimmed down, it's a little more understated, but it's still got that beautiful leather look. It has the speed hooks. All around a great shoe. Now, full disclosure, I actually bought, in most of these pairs, I bought two. One in a size 9.5, one in a size 10. If you see my other videos, you'll know that I'm a true size 10.5 in most, you know, athletic shoes, Slip-ons, CVs, whatever. But in boots, I've been noticing that going a whole size down is actually been pretty good for me. So in these boots, this is a 9.5. This fits me pretty well. Again, it's got that good snug feel right off the bat, which I think is gonna break in well to a good fitting boot. So consistent with my other purchases for Red Wings, 9.5 seems to be the way to go. Now, one note on the sizing, something I got separately for my Thursday boots that didn't quite fit well. I don't know if you remember the video, but I had a pair of Thursdays I bought in a size 10 and they kind of broke in and fit pretty large. I ended up getting these Red Wing inserts, a leather insert with kind of a cork foam footbed. I think it's cork, can't tell. This insert, if you actually put this in the Red Wing, the 9.5 does not fit at all. It's way too tight. I noticed if I put this insert in the 10, then it fit me pretty well. So I think what you're gonna wanna do is, if you're looking at, you know, going down a size, a half size, or if you find a deal on, say, a 9.5 but not a 10, or a 10 but not a 9.5, know that you can kind of play with the sizing a little bit by using these inserts. I think it looks like a pretty high quality insert that'll last a while. They sell them for like $40 on Amazon, and could be something you need just to get you to the place where the sizing fits you. So side note on that. Yeah, so first look, here's the copper rough and tough Blacksmiths. Oh, one thing to note on these shoes in particular, Vibram sole. Red Wing used to have, I think, their own proprietary leather sole. This looks like they switched over to Vibram recently, which I like. I think Vibram makes really great soles. And this one looks like it's gonna follow in the vein. Really hardy, looks like it'll last a long time. So yeah, there it is. Okay, next up we got the concrete rough and tough leather 6-inch mock toe. Now the mock toe is something that is a little outside my style range. Kind of an interesting look, interesting silhouette, but at the price point that I was buying these at, I kind of wanted to give it a shot. So let's check this one out. There they are. So these guys, yeah, so this is in the concrete leather. Put that on to the side. Again, same type of leather as the Blacksmiths that I just showed you, just in a different color. Really nice color in my opinion. I like this kind of charcoaly brown look. It's probably not something that you're gonna have in a lot of other shoes in your wardrobe. So really nice right off the bat. Now, the interesting thing about this one, which we'll figure out, is the box, you can see there, is marked factory second. So this one says it's a factory second, but if I look at the, oh, there it is. I just missed it the first time. Look at the tongue here, there is the punch. So yeah, it is punch, it's factory second. Again, I really, and maybe if you can comment or say something, and if anyone out there knows and can speak to the fact as to why you'd want to buy just straight from Red Wing rather than the factory second, please let me know, because right off the bat, I cannot see anything terribly wrong with this boot. Again, like maybe here, similar to the other boot, I see a little bit of variation in the grain. In my opinion, I think that just looks cool. If you're gonna wear leather boots, you're gonna wear them out, you're gonna get that nice, sort of the patinaing, the variation in the oils and the variation in the grain. I think it's just gonna give you a better look over time. So to me, that's not a negative. Maybe to some people it is, but I don't know, for a boot like this, this isn't something you're gonna be wearing around the office that much. I mean, personally, I'm in Silicon Valley, so yeah, I am gonna wear this around the office. But if you're in somewhere like New York or Chicago, working for a professional services firm or for, you know, kind of a button-down corporation, something like that, most likely this is not inside your dress code, or it's gonna be a little bit on the edge. So more than likely you're gonna be wearing this kind of as a work boot, kind of as like a nice casual boot with your raw denim and the rest of your workwear style, and beating this up and making it look really rugged is gonna be what you wanna do. So having that variation in the leather grains, again, not a bad thing, kind of a positive for me. Really quick thing to mention on this one, we have a double stitching and a 360 degree Goodyear welt. That just speaks to the craftsmanship that Red Wing has on these shoes. I mean, you see you have the triple stitched with the accent stitching here. The double stitch around the Goodyear welt is something that's pretty popular with the work boot style, to give it that really like rugged, bulky look with, you know, two-toned accent stitching. Looks great in my opinion. You've got this big, nice, chunky sole here, which is actually gonna be really comfortable. Compared to like the Blacksmiths with your classic hardcore Vibram sole, walking on this is gonna feel a lot better. It's gonna be a lot softer step. Again, sort of the contrast laces here. Now the sizing on this one I found to be a little different. Again, I determined that I wear kind of like a 9.5 in these, and I'll talk about it a little more when I get into the other boots. But on this boot in particular, the 9.5 US was a little bit small actually in the toe box. I could feel my toe hitting the front of the shoe, which is something when you're sizing boots, your toe should never run into the front of the boot, because the boot's gonna break in, you know, this way, it's gonna break in your heel, and upwards a little bit, but the leather generally isn't gonna stretch forward. I think that's just kind of common sense. So you wanna get a boot that fits you right in the length of your foot, but feels good and snug on the rest of your foot. And this one, well, the rest of my foot felt okay. Having the toe hit the front of the toe box is just not something that I'm willing to roll the dice on for a boot that I wanna wear for a long time. So I actually tried on the 10s in these, and I did, kind of like I mentioned earlier, put that insert in there with the 10s. It felt pretty good, but not great. Or I don't really want a shoe that's gonna break in that I have to use an insert in, I guess. So again, if you really like this shoe, you really wanna wear it, I think you can get away with going a half size up, putting the insert in. But for me, I'm probably gonna return this one, even though I do really like the leather. I think that contrast stitching is really nice and rugged looking, and this is like a classic mock toe look. But on the other hand, I think just with sizing, like, you can't wear a boot that doesn't fit. And that's probably where I'm gonna leave it for this one.